why Wall Street came to Wisconsin this weekend. The protests against corporate greed and the widening income gap started in New York's financial district and have now spread to other cities, big and small. What is at the heart of this movement? Today we're asking former Democratic U.S. Senator Russ Feingold, who is now a visiting professor at Marquette University Law School and writing a book on America post 9/11, also heads a progressive political action committee. It's good to have you back on the program.
Good to see you again, Mike.
Before we talk about Occupy Wall Street, your take on the recall effort targeting Governor Walker.
Well, it's justified. I'm not somebody who thinks you do recalls lightly. Elections have consequences, and people generally have a right to serve out their term. But what Governor Walker did was tear the state apart and go right at the throat of working people at a time when they were already suffering. And the tactics that were used were so harsh and so extreme that I do think it is an occasion where a recall should be attempted, and hopefully it will succeed.
And under no circumstance, you're a candidate in that recall.
I will not be running for that office during the 2012 election cycle.
Let's spend a few moments on the Occupy Wall Street protests. I saw an interview with you earlier in the week where you just said you not only understood the protesters, but you were excited by what you were seeing. Why are you excited by that?
Well, it's because I can't believe how long people get kicked over and over again before they start to respond. Here's a situation where people who had nothing to do with creating this economic disaster that occurred in this country in 2008 are suffering. Wall Street continues to get away with murder, basically. They don't have any serious regulations. Even the new law that passed wasn't strong enough. They're still making money hand over fist. Trade agreements were passed for two decades that shipped Wisconsin jobs and American jobs overseas. What happened yesterday? Oh, they said, we got something done in Congress. More trade agreements that are unfair for working people in this country. Now corporations can put unlimited amounts of money into political campaigns without even saying what they're doing. The whole system is set up against hardworking people in this country, and they're suffering, and finally they need to do the only thing they can do when the government and the corporate world won't listen to them, and that is to protest. And so I'm excited that people are standing up for themselves.
The protests have taken their fair share of criticism, as you know. And I wanted to read something to you from David Brooks, a thoughtful columnist for the New York Times. He said, if there is a core to the Occupy Wall Street movement, it's that the virtuous 99% of society is being cheated by the richest and greediest 1%. This is a theme that allows the people in the 99% to think very highly of themselves. All of their problems are caused by the nefarious elite. What do you think of that?
I think he's one of the elite. I think that this is a tone that he never used toward the Tea Party. He never applied those kind of tests to the incredibly amorphous agenda that the Tea Party had. Many times when I listened to their statements, they seemed to be sort of generalized anger. And you know what? That's fine. That's what protest is all about. You know, people that are protesting around the country don't claim to be thoughtful commentators. They're not trying to file a brief with the United States Supreme Court. What they're saying is, you ripped us off so many times that we're not going to be fooled anymore. And that's exactly what people should do when the elites in Washington and New York, including the media, they're all one happy family, forget that the working people of this country are truly suffering.
What about this analogy that this is the left's version of the Tea Party? The Tea Party folks don't like that. I assume probably there's some on the left who don't like that either. Is that just a false analogy?
The left didn't invent protesting. The Tea Party didn't invent protesting. Wisconsin, despite the huge protests this year, didn't invent it. It is the American way. It is not copying anything. And in fact, I find it odd that Tea Party people apparently are opposing some of this criticism of Wall Street. When the Tea Party started, they were saying things like, why did this Wall Street bailout occur? Now they're taking the side of Wall Street. How is that possible? I'll tell you why. Because they've been co-opted. The Republican Party and those who defend Wall Street have co-opted the Tea Party. These people are the real McCoy. They are people who are saying, we are tired of the very well-to-do in our society bearing no responsibility and getting all the good deals.
What would you liken this this protest to? Is there something that is a more fitting analogy than what we just discussed?
It can be like the populist and progressive movements that occurred in the United States in the late 19th and early 20th century, the so-called response to the Gilded Age. People like Fighting Bob La Follette, to some extent Teddy Roosevelt, although he was more moderate, William Jennings Bryan. These kinds of people were symbols of a mass movement in this country to say, wait a minute, there comes a point where a corporate domination, not only of the economy, but also of our political system is wrong. And that's where we are right now. It's not just corporate domination of the economy. It's corporate domination of our democracy. And people are tired. I think it's similar to that, and I hope it grows and affects real change in this country.
How much of the responsibility for the frustration people feel that you see in these protests is the result of policies by the president?
Well, obviously, the president could always do more. I disagree with him on some of these trade agreements. I disagree with him on some aspects of his tax policy. But fundamentally, he is far closer to the views of working people in this country than any of the possible Republican candidates. We have a chance with Barack Obama for some kind of tax equity. We have a chance for some fiscal responsibility. We have a chance for addressing some of the abuses on Wall Street. With all the candidates that are up right now, we would have no chance at all. So you can blame the president a little bit. I would mostly blame the Bush administration. But the blame isn't the issue here. It's responding and changing the system the way it is, and I think that's exactly what these protests are all about.
Former Democratic U.S. Senator Russ Feingold, thanks for being on the program today. Appreciate it. Next, the fascinating question surrounding Wisconsin's Republican U.S. Senate primary.
Upfront is produced with editorial assistance from WisPolitics.com, an online government and political news service.